Hello and welcome to another video on how to use MobiLock for your iOS devices. This is the second part of the VPP tutorial. Earlier, we learned how to enroll the VPP token and make MobiLock the VPP manager for your Apple volume purchase program. We also learned on how to sync your free and paid apps onto the MobiLock VPP asset management. Here, you can see that I have three apps. Now, in this tutorial, we will see how to go about publishing them, how to know about the number of licenses that are available, and actually see it being installed on the device. As mentioned earlier, for the sake of the demo, I have already one device that is registered on my dashboard. I had created one Apple profile so that I can publish the apps to this profile. With that, let's go ahead and navigate to the Enterprise section and My Apps. If you would like to publish the Apple App Store apps, go ahead and navigate to Apple App Store. Here, you would see the two applications that we have already purchased using the VPP program. This is the paid one, and this is the free one. Note that the VPP apps are denoted as with a watermark here, indicating clearly that these are VPP apps. Once you click on the app, on the right-hand side, you would get this dialog which will tell you how many licenses are available. This information tells you that how many total iOS devices you have, how many devices was it published to, and how many was it actually installed to. Now, let's go ahead and publish Dropbox onto my device. Let's see what happens. I'll go ahead, click on Publish, and I click on the profile. And I click on Publish here. Let me bring up the device so that we can see what happens there. Now this is the device. A push will be sent to the device, and once the device receives the push, it'll start downloading and installing the application. As you would see, on this device, I have intentionally not registered into any iTunes account so that you could see that the apps can be silently installed without actually registering onto the iTunes or signing onto the iTunes on the device. Let me refresh the page here. So as you could see, now the number of licenses has reduced by one. There are total five and only four are available. If you click on the view status, the app has still not started installing on the device, and that's why the status shows as zero. I'm waiting for the push to be coming on the device. Let me go ahead and publish another app meanwhile. So as you could see, I've clicked on this app, click on Publish, click on the VPP profile, and click on Publish. Let us go ahead and see on the device if the apps have been downloading. Okay, here you see now the Dropbox is being downloaded on the device. Similarly, once the Dropbox is downloaded, it'll start the data usage app also. As you could see, both the apps are being downloaded. This did not require any user interaction. It did not require any iTunes setup on the device, and you were able to install both free and a paid app. Now let's go back to the dashboard. Let's refresh the page. As you would see, the number of licenses that are consumed for this paid app has also decreased. There are only four available now, which indicates that you can publish this to four more devices. What if your device profile has more than five devices? Then, when you're trying to publish, you would get an error that the number of licenses are insufficient. You would have to go ahead and buy more licenses before you could publish onto that device profile. From here, you can also see where all this has been assigned. As you could see, this is the device where it has been assigned. You can go ahead and sync the licenses or purchase more licenses. This is similar to what you do in the VPP asset management. Now, the final part of this video will tell you that if you are migrating from another provider, another MDM provider, and you have synced your VPP apps, then how to reclaim those licenses that are consumed by earlier MDM provider? You can go to Apple Setup under Device Enrollment. Click on the VPP tab. Click on the VPP apps. Click on the option and click on View Assignments. If you have migrated from any other provider, say for example, let's go ahead and see the data usage. If you have migrated from any other MDM provider, then there would be an action to reclaim. If this is the first time that you're using and using MobiLock as your MDM provider, then the reclaim option would not appear. But if you're migrating from another MDM provider, a reclaim option would be appearing here. You can reclaim them and then distribute it via MobiLock. Hope this video helps you on how to publish your VPP applications using MobiLock and enable silent installations. Thank you.